Hey, how would you summarize your meeting with Robin Magic?
It was good. Just congratulate me on the season, individually, and you know us growing as a team. So it was good.
What did you think of your season based on what your expectations were leading into it, and then how things changed as you were coming off the bench at first, and then started and built momentum?
I couldn't have seen like or prepared for the start of the season. I didn't see it starting as that, but I think it made me kind of like who I am, as a person, as a player, and helped me grow. So I think as the season got on, I just came about. I just got better and better, and just more confident, and I'm excited for the off season.
So
just congratulating me. Really on the season, like I said, for my play and, from the start of last offseason to where we are now. So, it was short and sweet. It was good.
Did you guys talk at all about this summer?
Kind of not. They just said to, be in contact and talks with my agent and stuff like that. So. We'll see what happens.
Hey, Julius, when you talked about not being able to really prepare for the things at the start of the season, assume you're talking about no extension offer and then also coming off the bench to start the season. How did each of those things, help you refocus or motivate you going into this once those occurred?
It was more the basketball aspect. It really wasn't a contract. I kind of expected the contract then as far as the extension. But it was more so like the basketball, just not really expecting not to start and all that type of stuff. But, once I finally settled into my role, coming off the bench and then just continue to get better and then, got my chance to start and just continue to get better from that role. It was good.
Julius, so you played 82. What did that mean to you? And then also, just like when you're coming into the draft, this is an uncertain time for you. How are you? Are you mentally prepared or concerned, anxious? What are your feelings on heading into free agency?
Man, bro, this thing pick up everything.
Yeah, that's what I was saying.
Oh man, what'd you ask me?
So just you played 82. What did that mean to you? And then what are your feelings
in that? This 82 was really good, honestly. For me, only playing 14 minutes or whatever it was, my rookie year, breaking my leg and missing, 81 games. And then, for me, 4 years or 3 years later or whatever it is, to be able to play all 82, that was really cool, for me. You don't really go into the season knowing if you're going to play 82 or not. But for me, that's just like, the work I did with my trainer C's during the summer, all the work we did in the weight room to be able to prepare, for the style of play that I want to play, that coach, was going to ask of me, the front office asked of me, and to be able to do that night in and night out for 82, that was for me a huge accomplishment, something that I'm very proud of for sure. And then as far as the summer, I mean, who knows what's going to happen? I've never done this before, so I can't really speak on how things go or not. I know it's just going to be a longer summer than, what I want it to be. Wishing we were in the playoffs, but I mean, I don't know how it's going to go, man. You probably know better than me. Yeah, I'm excited for sure. I think overall for me, the season was a success. So, I feel like I played well. So I think it's exciting for me. Not really anxious or anything. I'm just excited now to really just prepare for the off season and the work, that I'm ready to put in for the off season to come back, a better player. And then I'm excited to be at home with my wife and my son now to be able to wake up and play with him every day. So that's what I'm excited about. I'm not really, anxious about that.
Joyce, were you just going into this year, do you feel like there was maybe from a vision perspective or preparation perspective? Did you just have a better idea what you wanted to accomplish going into this year than maybe previous years?
You're talking about last offseason going into the season?
Yeah.
Yeah, for sure. I knew, you know, really what I wanted to work on as far as, you know, changing my body and all that type of stuff and using my physical, you know, attributes, you know, my physical gifts and really using those to the best of my ability. So I kind of knew a lot more going into this offseason, what I wanted to work on. And I think this offseason I know even more, you know, just based off of, you know, how I played this year, what I want to work on going into this offseason.
And did a lot of that have to do with some of those exit meetings that you had from the front office?
Yeah, for sure. You know, Magic and Rob and Luke, obviously, those guys challenged us going into the offseason. And, you know, I think that really stuck with me and it really clicked, that exit meeting last year, for sure.
Julius, where did that work that you did with Amawala Caesar end up showing up on the court over the course of those 82 games?
For me, my conditioning, just natural movements, body control, explosiveness, recovery, all that type of stuff, man. Like, you get, like, little bang nicks and acts and banged up, but for me, like, night in and night out, just because I had a plan and, you know, it was very structured, I felt, like, really good going into every game. For the most part, 82 games, probably like 75, 78 of the games, like I felt really, really good as far as like legs and all that type of stuff. And, you know, thanks to Adam Silver too, because I think how they scheduled it with the less back-to-backs and the 4 and 5 and all that type of stuff, I think that really helped as well too. So, yeah, that what we did in the offseason, it helped me a lot this year, for sure.
Julius, this organization obviously is the only team you've known as a professional. Is it weird to think that when you walk out of here, this could be the end of your life? Yeah. I mean, it's obviously in the Lakers' hands going forward, but is that weird?
Yeah, I mean, it's a little weird. But I feel like I'm in a good position. So, yeah, I don't know.
Julius, you know, after they didn't give you the extension, what do you think you showed or proved to not only the Lakers but other teams in the league what you've done, what you can do, and also what do you want to happen this summer? Like, where do you want to end up?
I think, like I said, I kind of expected the extension thing. I think for me, I just hopefully prove, you know, the type of player I can be and show, you know, the growth that I can continue to have. I feel like there's so much room for me to grow. Just talking to Luke about that. Just so much room for me to grow as a player, to build on, you know, kind of what I did this season. So, yeah, that's that. And as far as where I want to be, like I said before, you know, this is a place that drafted me, you know, so obviously I have those ties to this place and I love it here. You know, great people, great organization, front office, just everybody in LS has been great. So it would be, you know, amazing to be here. And, you know, hopefully both sides can, you know, come to something. But I says far away, and we'll see.
Hey, Julius, you mentioned having a clearer picture of what you want to develop this offseason than last year. What do you want to add to your game this offseason?
You want me to give you the game plan, man? I can't give you the game plan. But I definitely do. I say I really know what I want to get better at, for sure. I ain't gonna tell you though, man. Sorry.
I was just curious if you have an opinion. I don't know if you've seen the back and forth between Donovan Mitchell and Ben Simmons. Have you?
Yeah.
So I was just curious what your opinion is, because you went through a situation where you barely played at all your rookie year, and then do you think that are there advantages? Do you think that somebody who's sort of had a redshirt year because of an injury has an advantage over someone who just came into the league?
Man, I don't want to take nothing away from Ben, because, like, Ben's been, like, absolutely amazing this year. I think it's kind of like both sides, though. If you really look at it, I think there's also an advantage of going to college for multiple years and coming into the NBA. I think guys are maybe sometime. But like one and done was good for me, but everybody's, you know, not necessarily prepared for that. Like, you know, Kuz was in college for a couple years and, you know, look at the year he had. So to both sides, but I would definitely say my mindset after I broke my leg and really knowing how to prepare and train for NBA season, going into like technically my second season, but like my first, was a lot better and it was a lot different. So I definitely think there's an advantage in that for sure. But I mean, both of those guys have had amazing years, so you can't hate on either one.
Julius, remember having this conversation last year about what you wanted to work on aside from your body, you know, hey, the jump shot, the right hand, and then it turned out that your go-to moves just worked, it seemed like, to a certain extent all year, and you were able to keep going to those strengths. Defenses didn't seem to be able to deal with it. Mm-hmm. So what has that taught you about how you can approach things moving forward and how to keep focusing on those strengths and still keep developing everything else?
Exactly what you just said. You know, I feel like I have, like, a foundation of how, like, I want to play. You know, how I can play, and then I feel like because of that, there's so much more room for me to grow because I know how to establish myself and how I want to play. So, I mean, you look at it, like, everywhere, any, like, star, any player in the league, everybody has tendencies. I remember, like, probably, like, 2 or 3 years ago, Kobe told me, he was, like, the, like, if you want to be unguardable, that's like the trick is for everybody to know what you're going to do and you still can't stop it. So I feel like, you know, everybody has tendencies in the league of, you know, their go-tos or what they want to do. And, you know, you just can't stop it because, you know, that's kind of like what they perfected. So for me, I feel like I have my foundation and then I can build off of that this offseason.
Going back to November, was there ever a point when you were coming off the bench and there were games where you played like 8 minutes? Was there a point when you felt like you needed a change or that this was over for you with the Lakers?
It was hard not to kind of feel that way. It was hard not to feel that way, not knowing if you're going to be here or not. But I couldn't really focus on it. Like, I didn't really have time to really focus on, you know, whether I'm going to be here or not. I just have time to really focus on continuing to get better and grow as a player, grow as a person, because the NBA season goes by so fast. So if I was dwelling on that, you know, when I had my opportunity, I could have missed out on it and not played as well.
Last question.
Julius, what would you, knowing, first of all, how good is this young core? How good can it be? And also, what would you tell a max free agent who was thinking about coming here about what these guys can do and what how he would be able to fit in?
What would I tell a max free agent? I don't know. I haven't thought about that. I'm a free agent myself, so I don't know what I'd be telling anybody else. but man, these dudes are workers more than anything. And you see, you know, throughout the course of the season, how these guys, how everybody has grown, you know, as a player, how we grew as a group together through the ups and downs, all the adversity, the highs, the lows, all that type of stuff. But I think the one thing that stayed constant for every single person on this team is day in, day out, everybody was working. And everybody had the mentality to get better every day. So, yeah, it's probably the hardest working group of guys I've been around as far as the team-wise.